if I were to define the LTR network to someone, I probably would have them look around in the environment that they're in. And I would ask them questions about how long they think it has taken for that landscape that they're in to look the way that it does. And I think most people are aware that ecosystems change at a timescale, of years to decades. The LTR network opened up this avenue to studying nature at the timescales that nature changes.
The LTR network is 27 different sites from really different ecosystems: Arctic, Antarctic, mountain, forest, grasslands, oceans. We've got at many sites 30 years, 40 years, sometimes 50 or 60 years of data about how that system functions. So we have this incredibly deep knowledge.
The fact that we have 30, 40 year records, longer in some instances, allows us to do these long-term studies of subtle climate change, of subtle variations in ecosystems with changes in temperature, precipitation, soil moisture. These are the kinds of things that allow us to see through the noise, to really ask and answer these really big questions.
I think a lot of people think of long-term research as just monitoring the system for tracking key variables of how species or biogeochemical processes or things like that are happening in the system. LTR researchers are actually laying out a whole series of experiments that manipulate key variables and then track the change over time when they're doing that. And it's that experimental design and tracking the change over time that is really central to how the LTR researchers address the questions they're interested in.